Hello, Earth citizens. In this video, I will show you a 10-minute routine to do for osteoporosis. Just a note, I am not a doctor, so this is not intended to replace the advice of your doctor at all. If you have serious conditions of osteoporosis, please consult your physician and not rely on this video. The intention of this video is just to show you some exercises to help you manage some of the symptoms of osteoporosis, but it's not guaranteed to heal anything, so please don't use this video in that kind of way. So now that we got that part out of the way, let's talk about osteoporosis. When you have osteoporosis, some exercises that are very good to do are low intensity aerobic exercises, strength training exercises, resistance training exercises, anything to build your muscles, build some strength into your bones. I got this information from an article by the Mayo Clinic. If you're curious to see the full article where I'm sourcing this from, feel free to click the link in the description below. The Mayo Clinic says that it's important to do exercises that build hip, leg, and lower half of your body. So we're gonna do some exercises that stimulate that area first, and then we'll do some other resistance type exercises that you can do at home without any weights or any bands. All right, let's get started. First, we're gonna walk lightly in place to get the energy going. So please lift your legs. So lift your knees like this and feel the bottom of your feet. If you can, try to walk a little bit forward. So you're not leaning back onto your heels, you're leaning a little bit forward. Your body weight is in between the ball and the arch of your foot. It would help if you swing your arms too. Swinging your arms will help you open your chest to get energy flowing more actively. Let's take 30 steps. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 20. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 30, and stop. Great job. Now bring your feet shoulder width apart, a little bit wider actually than shoulder width. We're gonna do some squats. So let's do 20 squats. If it's too difficult for you, please listen to your body and adjust to your physical condition. Hands on your waist, 20 squats. 1, 2, 3. Imagine you're pushing from the bottom of your feet. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 more. Are you feeling warmer? 1. Heat means energy circulating in your body. You're doing great. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 20. Okay, shake your arms. All right, now let's do some resistance type exercises. So first, bring your right arm out. You're gonna use your left hand to push against your right arm as you pull your right arm in. So in essence, you're using your own body weight to push against your own weight. So watch, push against your right arm as you pull in like this, okay? So this kind of resistance training will help you build strength in your muscles and bones. All right, let's start with right arm first. Let's push in for 5 seconds and then release, okay? Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Release. Whew. Let's do 2 more times on this side. Start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Release. Can you feel your body getting hotter? Last one. Resist. One, two, three, four, five, release. Great. Now switch. Left arm like this, right hand on top, and you're going to do the same thing. Push with your right arm, pull with your left arm, so you're using your weight against each other. All right, ready? One, two, three, four, five, release. If you need to, you can slow down and take a few breaths. All right, number two, ready? One, two, three, four, five, release. Last one. Number three. One, two, three, four, five, release. Woo, shake it out. Great job. Now let's do the legs. So with the legs, you're gonna bend your knees a little bit like this. Use your palms to push against your knees. So please don't push against your kneecap. That's very dangerous. Push against your actual leg, the side of your leg here. So you're gonna squeeze in with your legs. Squeeze in with your arms while you try to push with your legs. So you're using the resistance of your body weight against each other again. All right, ready? Let's do three sets. You're gonna really squeeze from your body. Push, push out and push in at the same time. All right, ready? One, two, three, four, five, release. Woo, can you feel in your leg and your arms all together? All right, two more. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, release. Ah, last one. Ready? One, two, three, four, five, release. Shake, shake, shake. Ah. All right, hands on your abdomen, take a deep breath in. Exhale. Again, deep breath in. Exhale. One more time, deep breath in. Exhale. Great job. Now let's do tapping on our body for just a few minutes. If you have a stick, something like this, even better. When you do light tapping of your bones this way, it creates some kind of resistance and it creates strength. So this is actually a very ancient type of training that martial artists used to do, and they still do in East Asia. When they want to strengthen their muscles and bones, they slam their bodies against a tree. So they slam their arm against the tree trunk, they slam their back against the tree trunk. The idea is that the more you hit something, the more stronger, the more resistance it will build. Kind of like callus, you know, when you keep pushing on your fingers, your skin forms a callus as resistance to the pushing. Same idea. So let's tap the bones. If you don't have a stick, something like this, maybe like your ladle or some kind of thing that you can tap your body is best. If not, worst comes to worst, you can use your palms. All right, so just tap all over your bones. Focusing on your bones. And go everywhere on your body. Especially in areas that you know you have some tension or sensitivity or some weakness. Let's do a couple more seconds, 10 more seconds. Make sure you're breathing too. The breathing out will help you release tension from your body. Five, four, three, two, one, and stop. How do you feel? Just doing one routine of 10 minutes isn't enough to completely reverse the symptoms of anything, but especially something like this, for something like osteoporosis, it's best if you do the little sets every single day for consistent practice. Because doing this every single day will help you build the energy, build the muscles, and hopefully build the bone density little bit at a time, so that after a little while, you'll see some great changes in your body. I especially want to recommend the tapping of your bones. You can even do this when you're watching TV or reading a book, doing something when you're sitting down passively and you don't have anything to do. Just tap your body and you can kill two birds with one stone. When you're watching TV, you can just tap your body and it'll help your body build some strength and muscle as well. You did a great job. To experience a full 1-hour brain education-based class, please visit a local Body and Brain Yoga studio near you.